guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I am Kasturi and you're watching Musk on the Move. I know everyone must be really busy in preparation of Diwali, but I just wanted to check in and share some things with you guys that can help you make your Diwali more sustainable, keeping in mind the environment and our nature. Alright, so without taking much of your time, let's get into the video. Let's start with the first thing that Diwali is actually known for: Festival of Lights. We spend a lot of money in getting all kinds of lights to decorate our house, bahar se bhi aur andar se bhi. And then we spend a lot of money on fancy candles, colorful diyas, etc. Instead of all these fancy things, why not go old school? Hum jitni bhi electric lights khareedte hain, they consume a lot of energy. Candles and all those fancy diyas emit a lot of toxic chemicals, which is not good for you or the environment. And Diwali kya yaar, jisme traditional earthen diyas na jalaye jaye. Agar aap ghar pe bahut sari cheeze bana rahe hain, jaise gujiya, samosa and all of that fried stuff, don't throw that oil out. You can instead use that oil in your diyas. Alright, coming to the second thing that I wanted to talk to you about is Rangoli. I mean, those colors are so toxic for the environment because they are non-biodegradable, and also for humans and pets. If you are looking for a change or if you are looking for a more sustainable option, I would suggest, again, do it the traditional way. Go old school, man. I mean, in this, you can experiment so much. Use leaves, use flowers, use turmeric. Use all kind of pulses that you get, you know, dal, chawal. You'll get so many colors. I mean, you won't have to go shopping for colors. You can just go to your kitchen, grab a bunch of pulses and start making your rangoli. Alright, so let's talk about clothes. I mean, that is one thing which is very important to us, right? You know, you want to look your best in Diwali. But the thing is, hamare purane naye kapdon ka kya? There are so many clothes in our wardrobes that we don't even touch. Ek bar pehen liya ya pehna hi nahi hai, bas rakha hua hai. But just because it's Diwali, we go out and we shop. So why not just go into your closet and recreate something and come out with a very creative outfit? I mean, ye to galat ho hi nahi sakta hai. Just put on some beautiful jewelry, you'll be good to go. So this Diwali, I recommend you guys to shop from your own closet and recreate a piece for your Diwali. Coming to the next thing, Diwali is all about lights and, you know, celebration, because it's a festival where we tend to exchange gifts. Whatever gifts that you bring has a lot of plastic in them, be it new clothes or any kind of showpieces. Point here is, instead of gifting the same old chocolate ka dabba or something like that, why not go for something more thoughtful and mindful? It's a very transferable kind of a thing, you know, a contagious thing. If you give somebody a plant as a gift, that person might not give you a similar thing, but jab wo kisi aur ko gift kar rahe honge, to that person will have this thing in his or her mind that why not give them a plant. And you can be the person to start that kind of a, you know, vibe, that kind of a gift culture, gifting culture, where we are giving things which are more thoughtful and which are just not the same old. I mean, if there is a gift wrap dabba, you know, like a flat dabba, I would know that there is chocolate in it. You can gift plants, you can gift money plants, bonsais, you can gift plates and, you know, bowls made out of coconut shells, you can gift them steel straws, you can gift things like bamboo brushes, shampoo bars, conditioner bars. Of course, these are very unconventional gifts, but somebody got to start it, man. It's high time that we realize that even if we are gifting something to someone, it should be thoughtful enough that we are considering the environment. Also, while gifting, make sure that your gifts are not wrapped in plastic. You can use recycled paper, you can use newspaper, and if newspapers are not very exciting for you, then go for handmade papers. Alright, so my last advice is, and I'm sure ye sabne bahut bari suna hoga aur is pe to itne issues ho rahe hain, are the crackers. I don't know why people are still using crackers for Diwali. Iske harmful consequences countless hain. I mean, there's no end to it. Still, if you are so keen to burst crackers on Diwali, agar aapko lagta hai ki Diwali nahi hui hai without bursting crackers, then I would recommend you guys to burst crackers which are made out of recycled paper. And if you decide not to burst crackers, that will be the best scenario, guys. Hamare pets or stray animals ke liye to ye tyohar se zyada saza ho jati hai. Before wrapping up this video, I just wanted to share one more thing with you guys. आपके घर में जो भी सामान है जो आप यूज नहीं कर रहे हैं, कपड़े, खाना, बर्तन, anything that you've not used for a really long time, make sure that you're donating it to people who are in need. Unki bhi to Diwali manni chahiye na. People who can't afford new clothes or nayi nayi achhi achhi mithai or all these things, unse apni Diwali zarur share kijiye by donating the things that you don't need anymore. I'm gonna wrap up this video by saying that always count your blessings, guys. Be thankful and stay humble. Alright guys, I wish you all a very, very happy Diwali. And I'm gonna see you guys after Diwali with a brand new video. Till then, have fun and be sustainable. And if you like my videos, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And don't forget to comment down below how your Diwali went. And if you have any new ideas on how to celebrate this Diwali more sustainably, do comment that down below as well. Also, follow me on Instagram, guys, at muskonthemove to see how I celebrate my Diwali. Alright, and I'm gonna see you in my next one. Bye. Happy Diwali.